Hello and welcome to another video of Rethink Biology. Today's topic is the termination of prokaryotic translation. Please go through the previous videos on initiation and elongation of translation before watching this. Links are given in the description below. The process of elongation persists until the ribosome encounters one of the three stop codons, UAG, UAA, or UGA. Stop codons differ from other codons as they do not correspond to any amino acid, hence no standard tRNAs possess anticodons that are complementary to those stop codons. Proteins known as release factors or RF aid the ribosome in identifying the termination of the polypeptide chain. These RFs interpret the stop codon and trigger a sequence of termination events that are highly specific. There are three RFs in E. coli, RF1, RF2, and RF3. RF1 is responsible for recognizing UAA and UAG, whereas RF2 is responsible for recognizing UAA and UGA. RF3, while not recognizing stop codons, plays a role in facilitating the events that follow termination. A stop codon is introduced into the empty A site as a result of elongation and ribosome translocation. The binding of RF1 or RF2 to the stop codon prompts peptidyl transferase to detach the fully formed polypeptide from its tRNA in the P site of the ribosome. Subsequently, the tRNA is removed from the P site of the ribosome, which is then followed by the release of the RF and the disassembly of the 70S ribosome from the mRNA. Finally, the ribosome disassembles into its separate 30S and 50S subunits.